the morning star, drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star, drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Friday, September 17th. This is the Morning Star Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening on this fabulous Friday? We got some coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, word study on the Wednesday message, and of course, Friday's Victory Rhymes with Yongsei. So how are you guys doing today? You guys must feel amazing because it's Friday. And yes, I feel amazing too. It's been a very, very good week. I was able to spend some time with my nephew. Yes, I am spending more time. I'm going to try to take him out about, you know, at least once a week. But last week, I took him to the zoo. This week, I took him to Legoland. Yes, I will put the pictures up on my Instagram. It'll be up there. But just enjoying my time with family at the moment. How about you guys? What you guys have any plans for the weekend? You know, if you do, just put it in the comments below. Would love to hear what you're going to do. For myself, I am going to do what I did for the last 2 weeks, which is relax. Yeah, I'm going to relax a little bit. But I am getting a little bit, what's that word, restless? Like, I think I need to do something. I need to start running, maybe start lecturing or something along that line, because I really feel like I should be doing something. Well, actually, the good thing is on my Patreon account, those of you guys haven't seen it yet, I did put up a word study and a little sharing I did with our Providence Club we have on one of the campuses here in LA. So that kind of gave me some strength to push forward. So I'm really, really enjoying this more than anything else. Just want to remind everyone to keep liking, commenting. Want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing. Just tell me how everything is going and what you guys got planned for this weekend. Also, Espresso with Sky channel, we have a new video coming out. Well, it already came out last night, and it's on Is There More Than Heaven and Hell? And it's a good intro for people to try to figure out the other places the Bible talks about other than heaven and hell. And of course, this could be a taboo subject for many people, especially people of faith. However, it's not telling people what is. It's people should be looking more deeply into the Bible, because the Bible does show places that are like that. So either way, for those of you who want to send it to your parents, your newcomers, whatever it is, it's a good video for them to watch. It's very reasonable and logical more than anything else, all right? And also, this Sunday edition, we're going to meet a member from Los Angeles. It's Mason Mendez. And the cool thing about this one is we are going to be filming right outside the church here in LA. And it's kind of a fun interview side by side. And I really, really enjoyed this one. Great interview. You guys got to watch this one too. Mason, great, amazing stories. I hope you guys check that one out also. And, you know, I really hope you guys are enjoying these Sunday editions and just really getting to meet other people from around the world in an intimate way. I'm hoping to have more interviews face to face, because that, you know, those are the ones that are a lot more, I don't know, I guess they feel a little bit more real more than anything else, okay? So I hope that you guys are really enjoying it more. Which means, let's get into some of the member artists from around the world. Who are we going to play today? Now, today's exciting. Why? Because it is a debut, brand new song, just came out from Juice Star Aiden Verdi from New Zealand. This is a new song, also has a music video, and I will put the link in the description so you guys can go check that one out too. This song, the new song, just came out today, is called Never Too Much. And of course, as usual, so grateful and thankful to Juice Star, because she always sends me these audios of why she came up with this new song. So we're going to hear that first before we get into the new debut, the song Never Too Much. The second song is Man and Groom from the Paper Music Associates in Korea with Cold Summer. And also we have another one from PMA in Korea, and it's J Root with the song Blaze. So first, let's listen to Juice Star and why she wrote this song and the meaning of the song. And then we'll get into the debut of her new song called Never Too Much.
Hi Morning Star Drive, this is my song Never Too Much. It's about two things. First, that we can love God as much as we want. So I read a old revelation somewhere, can't remember which one it was, from God that said, love me as much as you want and tell me anything. So God's heart is so big, right, that whatever struggles, depressions, problems we're going through, we can pour those into God's heart. And the second theme is my message to people of the world to not bottle their feelings in. They might feel like they have no one they can talk to, but to always feel at least you can talk to God. So don't keep something bottled in, afraid that it's going to burden someone or burden God and be too much, because it's never too much. So I hope you can enjoy this song and be encouraged to confess to God everything.
You want. 휴가 여름철만 다가오면 짜증나는 더위 끈적끈적한 여름엔 필요해 차가운 아이스크림 같은 한 여름밤의 꿈 빨리 안 먹으면 녹아서 끈적끈적해져 Like hot summer with mosquito 뜨거운 여름만 다가오면 싫지만 괜스레 두 군데는 이 기분은 뭘까 요즘 비가 오면 듣는 빗소리가 좋아 요즘 짝을 찾는 매미소리도 좋아 시끄러운 매미소리 밑에 가려진 매미들의 숨가쁜 사랑 노래 괜스레 얼굴이 빨개져 뜨거운 태양처럼 이젠 기대되다가 올 여름이
여름밤은 너무 더워 우릴 살려줘 열대야가 우릴 삼켜서 We will go 집에서 에어컨은 냉방병 걸려 갈 사람 줘요 갈 사람 넣어요 여름밤은 너무 더워 우릴 살려줘 열대야가 우릴 삼켜서 We will go 집에서 에어컨은 냉방병 걸려 갈 사람 줘요 갈 사람 넣어요
끝에 조금 처해 지난 핫서머데이 떠나볼까 젊은 날에 좋은 자리 있으면 좀 잡아도 꽉 막힌 도로여도 오늘은 기분이 설레네 계획은 딱히 없고 몇 시간 달린 후에 바닷가에 시원하게 발부터 담가 붙잡고 파도를 삼켜 또 모래성을 쌓아 석양 아래 바다와 모래 알이 너무 예쁜걸 어느새 더윈 잊었고 굳이 여자 없이 우리끼리도 즐겁네 그래도 저기 걸어오는 너희는 너무나 예쁜 거 어어 아쉬움 뒤로 한 채 우리 내년에 기약하자고
여름밤은 너무 더워 우릴 살려줘 열대야가 우릴 삼켜서 We will go 집에서 에어컨은 냉방병 걸려 갈 사람 줘요 사람 넣어요 여름밤은 너무 더워 우릴 살려줘 열대야가 우릴 삼켜서 We will go 집에서 에어컨은 냉방병 걸려 갈 사람 줘요 갈 사람 넣어요
내게 막혀 널 붙잡아줄 거니까 하루 종일 너의 꿈을 꾸게 될 거야 너의 아름다움 지켜줄 거야 just for you 변하지 않는 건 어때 상상이란 말은 절대 믿지 마 They will never know 네가 날 알아준 걸로 충분해 넌 바람 위에 날 빛으로 세우리 도시에 영원한 사랑 할 거야 with you forevermore you forevermore with you forevermore My love is
J-Root from the People Music Associates in Korea with Blaze before that Cold Summer from Man and Groom, also from PMA in Korea, and of course the debut of the new hot single from Juice Star Eden Verity from New Zealand, Never Too Much, and great song, and even more, what makes it even better is the meaning behind it. I'm really glad that Juice Star is able to give the meaning behind it, so we're able to kind of feel it more and where that process was of making this song. So thank you once again for that amazing song. We're going to play that more and more each and every week. Thank you so much for making more and more music for all of us here coming from God, all right? So that means we're going to get into some news going on around the world. We're going to start off with the coronavirus updates. In the world, there's 227.4 million cases with 4.67 million deaths, and that is 2.05% mortality rate. Top five countries going by daily infection rates and daily death rates, and the U.S. is hitting some big numbers. Well, they got 164,000 cases yesterday. However, the deaths are at 2,282. So this is huge. It's been a while since we've had any numbers over 1,000, but today we have a bunch of countries too hitting over 1,000. The UK, 30,000 cases, 201 deaths. India, 30,000 cases, 432 deaths. Turkey, 28,000 cases, 248 deaths. And Iran with 19,000 cases, 452 deaths. Now, over here in North America, of course, US is on top by far, but Mexico's not too far behind. Think about this, guys. Only 12,000 cases in a day, but Mexico has 1,046 deaths. Think about that. That's 1/12 of them are dying. So it's a huge thing when you think about this. Also, Canada, 4,200 cases in a single day with 43 deaths. So it's not bad, but the numbers are going up. Let's go into the top three news. Big thing when it comes to defense and alliances, the US, UK, and Australia agree to a new Indo-Pacific Security Pact. Australia will get nuclear-powered submarines as part of the deal. Now, it's dubbed the AUKUS, which is seen as an attempt to counter China. Australia, the US, and the UK have announced a new trilateral security alliance, including a joint effort to help the Australian military acquire nuclear-powered submarines in an apparent attempt to counter China. Now, the leaders of all three countries unveiled the alliance, dubbed AUKUS, A-U-K-U-S, on Wednesday, and they stressed that the submarines would be nuclear-powered, not carrying nuclear weapons. So Australia is a signatory to the Treaty of the Non-Proliferation of Nuclear Weapons, and What happened is, joined virtually by Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison and his UK counterpart Boris Johnson, US President Joe Biden said the three nations were taking a historic step to deepen their cooperation. The three leaders did not mention China explicitly in their remarks on Wednesday, but the Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesman Zhao Lijian slammed the new alliance as an extremely irresponsible threat to regional stability. The three countries, he said, were severely damaging regional peace and stability, intensifying an arms race, and damaging international nuclear non-proliferation efforts. This is what Li Jian told a regular press briefing. Now, Australia's Morrison said the newly announced partnership would deliver a safer and more secure region and ultimately benefit all, and Australia said it intended to build 8 nuclear-powered submarines under the agreement, and the announcement comes amid growing competition between Beijing and Washington and its allies in the Asia-Pacific, particularly over Taiwan and the disputed South China Sea, which China claims almost in its entirety, amid rival claims by several other nations, including Vietnam, the Philippines, and Malaysia. Now, Australia has also seen its ties with China deteriorate sharply amid disputes over the coronavirus pandemic, trade, and concern in Canberra about Chinese political influence operations. That's quite interesting to see this trilateral alliance happening here. We're going to go into Indonesia, because Indonesia was on top and they were going through this massive second wave of the coronavirus. But now they have quelled that wave, but is a new wave on the way? So daily cases and deaths have dropped sharply in Jakarta and Java, but experts say limited testing and contact tracing have allowed the virus to surge elsewhere in the archipelago. Now, official data in Indonesia shows a Delta-driven second wave of coronavirus that saw the Southeast Asian nation become the global epicenter of the pandemic in July and August, but it has run its course. Now, some of the country's top epidemiologists say poor testing and tracing capacity, inaccurate estimates on the death toll, and the deliberate falsification of data means there is still no clear picture of the pandemic in Indonesia, and a third wave could be brewing. Now, at the peak of Indonesia's second wave in July, a staggering 1 in 3 people tested for coronavirus in the country got a positive result. But the 7-day average positivity rate has now dropped to 3.64% and is still falling. So according to the National Board for Disaster Management, it's the lowest positivity rate the country has reported since the start of the pandemic, and a number that lies well within the 5% benchmark the WHO uses in it as an indication that countries with control of the virus. Now, Indonesia's daily cases, which reached a peak of about 56,000-57,000 per day on July 15th, and saw hospitals bursting with patients on the most densely populated island of Java, stood at 3,900 on Wednesday. Meanwhile, the official number of daily fatalities, which surpassed 2,000 in July, tumbled down to 267 on the same day, which is great news. Now, the situation in Indonesia is kind of similar to India, where there was a very sharp increase and a very sharp decrease because the Delta variant kind of ran out of fuel. But outside of Java, it's a different story. The trend for new cases in Indonesia has moved from cities to villages and from Java to outlying islands where they don't have enough capacity for testing. So most of these areas have performed poorly for 1.5 years, but then suddenly in 2 months, they've shown a major improvement, and this is the reason that people are not convinced by the data. So an epidemiologist advising the ministry, who spoke on condition of anonymity because they're not authorized to speak to the media, said to claim the data outside of Jakarta was unreliable and was a massive understatement. So the drop in the national positivity rate also reflects the falling use of PCR tests. So PCR testing has decreased from 60,000 per day to about 20,000. So it's the third, right, in the first week of September, which is really worrying in a country with a huge population like Indonesia, which is the fourth largest in the world. And Indonesia's official death toll is also inaccurate because the government's definition of a coronavirus death does not follow WHO guidelines. So they only include victims who died and who have received a positive response from a PCR test, right? And this is a very narrow definition and supports the conclusion that Indonesia is not yet producing the kind of clear and convincing data needed to show it has control over the pandemic. Now, from June to August, the official fatality rate for the coronavirus in Jakarta was 6,000, but in the same period, there were 18,000 excess deaths, in the city because there were thousands of people who died at home without being tested as they couldn't even get to a hospital. So a conservative, poorly organized, corruption and flood-prone archipelagic nation, home to the world's fourth largest population, vaccinating Indonesia was never going to be easy. And only 20% of the target adult population of 181.5 million is fully vaccinated, and 35% is partially, right? So this begs the real question, is a third wave, is it looming on the horizon in Indonesia? So, you know, using a pattern that shows the coronavirus peaking in Indonesia every 6 months, they say that the next wave could probably strike somewhere in January. Now, which vaccine are they using there? They're using the Chinese Sinovac vaccine, and it has been the efficacy rate of the Sinovac vaccine is 51% compared with 76% of AZ and well above 90% for Pfizer and Moderna. So that is something that is a little bit worrying, but of course, having a vaccine is much better than having no vaccine, okay? So that's the top three news. We'll get into sporting news. What's happening in the sporting world? Let's take a look at soccer first in Champions League. It was a really, really like huge anticipated event. Finally, for Paris Saint-Germain, they went against Club Bruges. And even though it was the first time Messi, Mbappe, and Neymar played together for the first time, however, total only four shots on target, and they didn't seem to have any gel or chemistry yet. And of course, it's their first game, so we'll see what will happen in the future. And disappointingly, they tied 1-1. In Major League Baseball action, we have the LA Dodgers, where I'm at right now. They clinch a playoff spot for the ninth straight season, and they're the second team to do so in the majors this year, with the San Francisco Giants being first. And of course, LA Dodgers are leading the entire league with the best record, 51 wins and 23 losses. And last but not least, in the NBA, some news. The NBA is not requiring all players to be vaccinated because 85% of players are already vaccinated. And I believe 100% of like staff and referees are vaccinated. However, there are some areas and states which are more strict. So the teams have to follow the state guidelines. So some of these states won't allow unvaccinated players to enter home arenas or team facilities, including games, unless they're approved of medical or religious exemptions. So that is a top three news, not just in the world, but also in sporting news. Hope you guys really enjoyed that. Kind of open your eyes a little bit more to what's happening around the world, which means we're going to get into the golden time. Right. And, you know, now that the worldly news is done, we need some golden time, a time to kind of, what do you call it? To bring our hearts and our minds into the right space. So we're going to start off with the grace of Thanksgiving, and then prayers work, and then please call me. And of course, one of the biggest themes we have right now is Thanksgiving and prayer. All right, so I hope that you guys will enjoy this time as one body of the Morning Star Drive, giving praise, honor, and glory to the Holy Trinity.
Lord, you've helped us open up our eyes and to give thanks with every word we speak. We all sing praise to God, the one who made and formed our souls and spirits. We all give thanks through songs of praise. He has been the warm rays of the sun, and he has been the fresh air that we breathe, the Spirit's warm embrace, and the sweet rain of grace sent down upon us. God, raise our spirits with his love. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changed into a bride, so Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there, my spirit's in your care. This stream of thanks and grace now overflows.
I thank you, Jehovah, Lord of hosts. I thank you, Mother of my spirit. I thank you, Holy Son, Lord of love. I thank you, my Lord. I thank you, Jehovah, Lord of hosts. I thank
you, I thank you, Mother of my spirit. I thank you, Holy Son, Lord of love. I thank you, my Lord. Lord, you've helped us open up our eyes and to give thanks with every word we speak. We all sing praise to God, the one who made and formed our souls and spirits. We all give thanks through songs of praise. He has been the warm rays of the sun, and he has been the fresh air that we breathe. The Spirit's warm embrace and the sweet rain of grace sent down upon us. God raised our spirits with his love. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changing to a bride. So Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now overflows. I thank you, Jehovah, Lord of hosts. I thank you, Mother of my spirit. I thank you, Holy Son, Lord of love. Thank you, my Lord. Through you, Lord, I have a brand new life. Now I can live as your beloved bride. I'll only love you, Lord, for you have taught me about the life of heaven. My spirit will rejoice and sing. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changing to a bride. So Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now overflows. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changing to a bride. So Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now overflows. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changing to a bride. So Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now overflows.
Prayer is work you must do, just as things get done when you make effort. Praying what you ask will be granted if your prayers meet God's heart. You should pray not just for yourself, but pray for your brothers, nation, and world. Pray sincerely, pray daily. It's the work you must surely do. God, the Spirit and the Son want to grant your earnest prayers, and finally, at the right time, they will grant what you responds with joy. Through prayer we solve problems. Yes, prayer is true power. When we were harmonious, God held back the tide, as he did that time in Mong San Po. Then the Lord gave the word, speaking to crowds on the beach. He taught about the final days, there before the crowds in Malaysia. Portix
stories. through those days. Tribulations struck like a storm, harsh winds of endless persecution. We were left questioning, can we meet with the Lord again? The ideal world, can it be fulfilled? We then thought we worried and wondered. I cannot forget all those times come. In the future, history would change like this, rising brightly. Truly, God, you're great, you're almighty, you're omniscient. Truly, my Lord, you're tenacious, powerful, you endure, you do it to completion. Cannot help but cry out, truly great, the Lord is truly great. We did well to believe and follow, truly we did. This is what I have realized here today.
That is Please Call Me, and of course that is also, it's another way of saying to pray, to call upon the Holy Spirit, right? And before that is Prayer's Work, and of course the Grace of Thanksgiving. So that was a time, that was a golden time, a time of praise and worship, and that's leading into the word study for today. And honestly, the Wednesday message, guys, I was just one part just blew me away. All right, guys, just mind-blowing. And that's the only thing I can think about. It's the only thing I can think about, and I think you guys know what I'm going to talk about, is how long Pastor Joan prayed just to get the message, just to get, like, when she says she's really trying her best. The last time I was able to have, like, some form of communication with her was just recently, and that's what she was saying. She was just saying, I'm going to do my best until the end to match God's time, this time of resurrection. And obviously, I guess the difference is a lot of times people say, oh, you know, this is the time, and they say it with their lips, but after hearing her say that, and then on top of it, hearing Sunseem talk, like testifying that she's praying like 7-8 hours a day, right? Or just to realize a message, she prayed for like 9 hours. For me, that is the most inspiring part more than anything else. I'm not sure about you guys, but tell me that your mind was blown, like at that point. Because at that point, I'm just like going, that's crazy. Like not crazy as in like, you know, like insane. Well, no, it is insane. It is insane, like insanely extreme. And it's exactly what Sunseem, like she's putting the words of God into practice beyond anything. 9 hours, that's like almost the entire time you're up. Like what else would you be doing? It's just eating, sleeping, praying, and you'll have just a little bit of time to do other things, right? So yeah, like just from that itself, like, I'm speechless. That's why, you know, I'm barely speaking right now. But just from that itself, it is so mind-blowing. And my heart was like, wow, this is really the time. It really, really is. And it's kind of like what Sunseem said, is we don't feel it or we don't understand it unless you take action. And the action that must be done right now is prayer. Now, I'm not saying that all of us, you know, some of us go to work, some of us have families. If you have children or babies, it's not like you can just put your baby aside and then pray for 9 hours. Like, you know, obviously we can't. But it just shows how extreme and how amazing it is, why she understands better than other people. And I'm going to be honest with you guys too, is even when we listen to the messages like in the last month, a lot of it is like, wow, it's so deep. And sometimes we have to listen to it over and over again. Like, man, what is it really saying? Like, I don't really feel it. And you realize why someone like Pastor Joan feels it. It's not because she is who she is. It's because she is because what she does. So things like putting the words into action to the extreme, like Sunseem says, this is why she is the person she is. And I'm going to be super honest with you guys. This is the number one thing that just blew my mind. It really did blow my mind. Too much to the point I'm just like, I can't think of anything else. I can't even focus on the other stuff since he was talking about, because this was a thing like, this is it. This is the reason, this is the way that we're going to get ourselves back to it, and we have to do it to the extreme. And it's very interesting because I think one of the things, the great things about having Pastor Joan is when we hear Sunseem do these things, it's almost like he's on such a different level that you're going to be like, yeah, well, Sunseem can do it, but me, I can't do what Sunseem does, right? It's going, you know, like in the form of faith too, it's like Jesus, right? Jesus will do what he does, and we're not going to be able to do what Jesus does. However, when Pastor Joan does it, she's on our level, right? She's not our level, but she's one of us. Well, Sunseem's one of us too, but you know, it's different. Pastor Joan's one of us. And she's young, like she's a year younger than me. And just to hear her do this is like, what? It's, for some reason, it's crazy. It's like living hope, right? It's, she's like a living, like, wow, if she can do it then, like if Sunseem does it, yeah, it's a little bit hard. But if Pastor Joan does, it's like, wow, you know what? We can do this. We really can. So I was just blown away. Really, really blown away. So that was a big thing for me. And, you know, if I were to add some other point, because, you know, that was the thing that stuck out more than anything else for me. And I hope it's something that we start to, the second point kind of goes into, we, you know, when Sunseem talked about the story of helping someone, I honestly barely heard it because I was still thinking about what Pastor Joan was doing. But the thing that got me was putting the word, you know, when you consciously just say, I'm going to put the words into action, it's different than realizing it from a part of your life. Like it's something natural that comes from you. So instead of having a sense of a responsibility, it's that natural wanting, you know, just having the message a part of your life. That's the difference between Sunseem and us, right? We're like, oh, I gotta put the words into action. I gotta put the words into action. We're constantly reminding ourselves, right? Like I see people who are always like, you know, have a counter, like, oh, how many times am I calling upon the Holy Spirit? That's more of a sense of responsibility. Right? So he says, don't just think this way. We have to take action, not just thinking about the message, right? We have to do it with all our heart, will, and life, going to the extreme, but it's going to be something that's normally part of our life, not a sense of responsibility. And that's something that we have to think about, like, oh, that's so true. That makes a lot more sense too. So even for me, I was like, yeah, that's something that we have to kind of make it, putting the words of God as a normal, active part of our life. And the only way that's going to happen is if we do it with all our heart, will, and life. So, yeah, like this week's message, it's really interesting because this week's message is not, you know, of course, it's about doing it together with God, but you can't do it together unless you realize it. And that's why I'm going back to the first point of prayer. I'm just like, wow, like we couldn't even think about doing it unless we really realize the message. And that's going to be, like as Pastor Joan said this week, the catalyst is prayer, right? That's the catalyst for all things, right? And that's the thing that's going to change the way we do things. And if we don't get this part done, then we're always going to be kind of stuck behind of, oh, why is it important? Oh, like if you don't realize it really well, you're not going to put it into action. And this is why working together with the Lord right now, the biggest thing we can do right now is prayer to get us into like the same mindset, right? On the same, like unify ourselves. And, we have to, Sunseem's not just asking us to do it. He's doing it together with us until the end. Because we've messed up so many times. He's been repenting for us like this week. Like, yeah, his prayers have been really deep. So even for me, it's nothing but prayer. And I think that's something that we have to really get our hearts to go into. And if we think about this too, he's like pleading with us. And there's that one point he made was... the words he's receiving right now, he shouldn't even give it to us until 10 to 25 years later. That's how amazing these messages are, but he should wait for us because we're not even on that level yet. And we have to be those that really understand it to that level, right? That's the value of these words. Oof. It's what it is. People who don't take action can't feel, right? They won't be able to feel the word, feel God. Even if you preach 10,000 times, you'll never feel it when you have to take action. And what's the action right away? Right now, it is prayer. Once, if we take action, if we're people who take action, the moment it's preached, we're on fire right away. Like, isn't that something you want? Just like that message just to pummel your heart, right? It just pop, 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 just makes you pop right away. The message goes straight into you. Even if they just say, Sunseem says one proverb, it just hits you like a ton of bricks. And that's what we want. So, man, yeah. That one part, Sunseem's like, if you don't take action, I don't have time to teach you that much, to 10,000 times, and that's why you just got to take action. Whew. I'm not sure, guys, what else I can talk about, because that part was just, it was such a big realization. How important, how big it is, and just the inspiration, motivation that she did. Like, she literally prayed 9 hours and 7 to 8 hours. It's just, oh, yeah. I don't know. Is there anything else that we can talk about from the Wednesday message? Or did you guys feel the same thing? Can you write that in the comments? I'm wondering, did you guys actually feel the same thing or not? Like, how big that was? Yeah. It was just huge. Huge. It was huge. Yeah. Yeah. I think Pastor Joan gave like the extreme education by extremely putting things into action. I guess the last words that Sunseem said was, if you don't take action, you're not fully resurrected. And action is a sign of resurrection. So pray. We got to pray. Pray and take action boldly. Pray for things to get demolished if they're against God's will. Pray for these slanderers. Pray for them to not be successful. So, yeah, I'm blown. I'm sorry. That was the big thing from the Wednesday message that really just exploded my mind. Either way, I hope, write in your comments what you guys got from it too. I'd love to hear what you guys realized also. Okay, so that is the Wednesday message. I know it was so small, but guys, it's a big thing. And that's why I picked this song, the song of choice for today. It's supposed to be Musical Friday, but because it's, a time for prayer, I realized even more. I was looking for a song, and it brought me back to the days of MC Hammer. Those of you guys who don't know MC Hammer, he has this amazing song called Pray. He's also a minister right now, but way back then, he even sang a song called You Have to Pray Just to Make It Today. So I hope you guys will enjoy this, and it'll inspire you even more. This is MC Hammer with... Pray.
That's what we pray. Pray. Pray.
We got to pray just to make it today. I said we pray.
Pray.
Oh yeah, we pray.
Pray.
We got to pray just to make it today.
That's what we pray.
All my life I wanted to make it to the top.
That's what we pray.
Some said I wouldn't, they told me no, but I didn't stop.
That's what we pray.
Working hard, making those moves.
We pray.
Oh yeah, we pray.
Pray.
And there you have it. That was MC Hammer with Pray. That, you know, tell me that's an inspiring song after we just talked about prayer for like, you know, like 10 minutes. So super grateful and thankful for all of you guys joining today. Amazing, amazing. MC Hammer with Pray. And I hope that Wednesday message, write your comments. I would love to hear what you guys realized and thought about it too. Which leads us into the last segment for today on this Friday podcast and also for the entire week. Once again, this is Victory Rhymes with Youngse.
What's up, everyone, and welcome to this week's segment of Victory Rhymes here on the Morning Star Drive. With me, I'm Youngse, and I'm South African. And I'll bring you the poetry, the poems, the stories, or the songs written by the brides of this history. And I really hope you enjoy it. When you've got to this part of the week, I mean, it's Friday, it's Fri-yay, you probably feel a lot of relief. But there's a day ahead of us, and let's not let this day just pass by and only think about the weekend, but let's make it count, and let's receive some inspiration of how we can make this day meaningful. And maybe today's poem was exactly what you needed to hear. So without any further ado, I'm gonna get right into it. Today's poem is a poem that I wrote. I can't remember when. But I think it was around, I think it was this year. Maybe like around June or something. And yeah, it's kind of a silly poem. Like it's a little bit like, imaginative. But yeah, we have all sorts of poetry here on Victory Rhymes. We have deep poems, shimjung poems, funny poems. Sometimes we have very like motivational poems, but there's something in every poem that will make you think and give you inspiration. And I hope that this poem is going to do exactly that for you today. So here we go. This is the poem I wrote to the Lord. I wish I could shrink myself and climb into your blazer. There I will cover myself up and live safely on your heart. Would I be able to live there? Your heart is so strong, Lord. I think I can't live with that loud beating noise. Then how about I mount myself on your back so I can wrap my arms around your chest and observe all you do from your shoulders? But you love planting trees, Lord. What if you bend over to look at the roots and I flop over and plant myself like a human pine tree? Oh, no, no, no. Then how about I live in your ear? Listen as you hear God's voice. But then what if I become a human earbud and block heaven's voice? No, not this. Well, then I want to live under your skin so I can be closest to you, as close as can be. But how can I breathe there? Oh, what a perplexing quest, my Lord. How can I satisfy this heart of never being close enough to you? Where shall I live? How about I climb up to the top and live in your brain? I'll live in your thoughts. Oh, at last, there is no distance at all. So there it is, my silly little poem written to the Lord. But it has deep meaning, right? Like, it is this earnest heart of wanting to be as close as possible to the Lord. And thinking, I just want to be under his skin, but that's a bit unpractical, isn't it? No, I want to be, okay, then can I just live like with him piggybacking me around all day long? Like, then I can see everything he does. Oh no, well, what if I just like fall down into the ground and get planted with all the other pine trees? Like, no, that's not gonna work. But then in the thoughts, when I live in the Lord's thoughts and when we connect in thoughts, there's no distance at all. And that's it. That's the thought I want to leave with you today, is we want to be as close as possible to the Lord. But what does that really mean? Does it mean that we are always holding hands with him physically, or that we can be next to him seeing what he does physically? No, of course not. Of course, that's not what it means. But really being close is connecting in thoughts, connecting in heart, in Shimjong, and taking action on the word together with him. The Lord comes to us through the word, and we need to take action on the word together with him. That's when we're really close, when we connect in thoughts, and when we make the word that the Lord gives us our thoughts. So then, yeah, this inspires me a lot. We all live in our individual places, and we all want to be as close as the Lord, to the Lord as possible. And the way to do that is to be one with him in heart and thoughts, in Shimjong. And now this is a time that we should really pray. It is a time that is set as a time of prayer, the 70 days prayer condition. And then Pastor John also mentioned that departments can set prayer conditions as well. And departments are doing that, setting their prayer conditions. And it's the time that we really need to pray together. And we really need to be one body connecting with the Lord and only taking the Lord as our head and doing it together with the Lord. And we need to do it with his thoughts. We need to be connected with his thoughts to be able to do it together in the same direction, work in one direction with him. So it really inspires me a lot to pray more with the word and really unite with the Lord's thoughts so that I can really run together with him as one and be as close to him as I possibly can. It's not about where in the world I live, but it's about how much I am united with the Lord in my heart and thoughts, and how much I take action on the word that he has given me with my heart, will, and life. And that's how we can live together. I hope that you enjoyed this segment today and that you have a wonderful day together with the Lord. And I'll be back again next week with another segment of Victory Rhymes. This is Yongse. Goodbye.
And thank you so much, Yongse, for another amazing episode of Victory Rhymes. And if you guys have any, anything that you want to contribute, go ahead and leave it. Send it to the email I put in the description. Everyone, awesome, amazing week. Hope you guys really enjoy your day, your weekend. Make sure that you go check out Mason Mendez Sunday edition. And then on Monday, we'll see you guys again on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive, 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know. I'm burning with desire and the passion.